Hello, welcome to this module on cosmetics. When we hear the word chemical, we think of something synthetic, basically something cooked up in a laboratory. However, ingredients which are extracted from plants and minerals are chemicals too. A natural ingredient is a chemical, and also a synthetic one is a chemical. It does not mean that just because it's chemical that it is essentially best for you. The body is built on chemistry. Everything around us is chemistry. We take it for granted most of the time. Cosmetics are an excellent example of how discoveries in chemistry are becoming a part of our day-to-day lives. They are used by both men as well as women, and their demand is so high that it has generated one of the largest industries on the planet. Just pick any one cosmetic product and read the ingredient label to see a long list of chemicals. Look at the ingredients label on a typical moisturizer or shampoo, and there will likely be a list of unintelligible chemical names which most of us won't have a clue what they are. The chemical composition of a product determines its effect on our body. In a society that lays great emphasis on looks, the cosmetic industry will definitely continue to flourish. People are becoming increasingly more self-aware about their appearances. And with this comes the birth of cosmetic industry. So let us see what exactly a cosmetic is. A cosmetic is any substance which is used to clean, improve or change the complexion of the skin, hair or nails. Cosmetics comprises a range of products which are used to care for the face and the body, and also to enhance or change the appearance of the face and the body. These products include skincare, personal care, cosmetics, and fragrances. So a cosmetic is any personal product that can be applied on the body. Cosmetics have three purposes. Firstly, they can be used to clean the surface onto which they are applied, such as shampoos, body wash, and face cleansers. Secondly, they can be used to replenish and protect the skin, such as toners, serums, moisturizers, and body creams. And lastly, they can be used to enhance one's appearance, such as makeup. There are thousands of cosmetic products available with different combinations of ingredients. People are commonly thinking of cosmetics as makeup, and these products include lipstick, mascara, eyeshadow, foundation, blush, highlighter, and several others. However, the legal definition of cosmetics is much broader in many countries. In the United States, the Food and Drug Administration, which regulates cosmetics, defines it as a substance which is intended to be applied to the body for cleansing, beautifying, promoting attractiveness or altering the appearance without affecting the body structure or functions. This broad definition includes any substance intended for use as an ingredient of a cosmetic product. So, understanding the fundamentals of chemistry and skin physiology are prerequisites to formulating personal care products. Besides active ingredients, other ingredients present in most cosmetics include water, emulsifiers, preservatives, thickeners, moisturizers, colors, and fragrances. The ingredients can be naturally occurring or artificial, but their potential impact on our health depends on the chemical compounds that they are made of, and not on whether they are natural or synthetic. So it is understood that the dose of potentially dangerous chemicals found in cosmetics are considered too small to pose a risk to human health. During the 20th century, the popularity of cosmetics increased rapidly. Cosmetic products are not required to demonstrate their effects scientifically in the same way that therapeutic products are. Their claims are usually termed in cautious language, such as may reduce the appearance of fine lines and wrinkles, many of these are not scientifically proven to be true. Cosmetics have been in use for thousands of years. The absence of regulation of the manufacture and use of cosmetics has led to negative side effects, deformities, blindness, and even death through the ages. So let us dive down through history to understand the origin and evolution in the cosmetic. Egyptian men and women used makeup to enhance their appearance. They were very fond of eyeliner and eyeshadows in dark colors using blue, red, and black. They crushed gemstones and used them to decorate their faces, mainly on the lips and around the eyes. All ancient civilizations used cosmetics. The ancient Greeks also used cosmetics as the ancient Romans did. Some examples are kohl, used by ancient Egypt as a protectant of the eye. Castor oil, used by ancient Egypt as a protective balm. Skin creams made of bee wax, olive oil, and rose water are described, which are used by the Romans. Cosmetic formed an integral part of the Egyptian life. Use of perfumes and ointment to mask the odor produced by the body and soften their skin was common. Myrrh, thyme, lavender, lily, peppermint, rosemary, and various other oils were frequently used. The animal fat was combined with fragrant substances such as myrrh to produce early skinned ointments. One naturally occurring material used by the ancients was red ochre, known as iron oxide. Lumps of iron oxide were formed when it oxidized or it rusted. Red ochre were also popular in cosmetics such as roux and lip color. In fact, those pigments are still found today in today's beauty products due to their availability and stability and non-toxicity. However, perhaps the most surprising applications of these materials is actually medicinal. The Herbs Papyrus, one of the oldest and most important medicinal texts from the ancient Egypt, dated 1550 BC, prescribes ochre clays as a cure for any intestinal or eye problems. Kohl, made from crushed antimony, burned almonds, lead, oxidized copper, ash, malachite, was used to define the eyes in the iconic almond shape, which is seen very commonly in masks and sculptures. They were used by both men and women. The color green held association with fertility and rebirth for the ancient Egyptian. Green eye paint composed was made of malachite. White complexion has been a symbol of beauty since ancient times, so much so that the aristocrats with darker skin would apply makeup to look pale. In Japan, lipstick made of crushed safflower petals was used to paint the eyebrows and edges of the eyes and the lips, whereas rice powder was used to color the face and the back. In Greece, a white look was achieved by wearing chalk or lead oxide, known as lead carbonate. The 13th century era, egg whites were used on the face to create the appearance of a paler complexion. Ceruse or lead white was used in the 1800s, and this was responsible for various health problems, including facial tremors and even death. In Europe, the main ingredient in the face powder was generally arsenic instead of lead. So, taking you to some did you know facts. Spirits of Saturn, also known as Ceruse, was a 16th century cosmetic used as a skin whitener. It was in great demand and considered the best available at that time. The Queen of England is popularly imagined to have been a notable user. Ceruse was also blamed for the death of Maria Coventry, Countess of Coventry, who was aged 27. She had been a frequent user of Seru's and is believed to have died of lead poisoning. The Queen of Egypt, Cleopatra, was considered the most beautiful woman, ascended to the throne at the age of 17. Because of a deep interest in perfumes and spa treatments, Mark Antony gifted her a spa and perfume factory built by Herod the Great at the south end of the Dead Sea. She had a book named Cleopatra Gynaecium Libri. This book recorded recipes for making cosmetics and perfumed ointments. The archaeologists have unearthed jars containing residues of ancient skin care product and that are claimed to be used by Cleopatra, which have been studied and analyzed extensively by chemists. Surprisingly, cosmetics today still use products that are found in her recipes. On further analysis of the residue from one jar of Dead Sea mud treatment, it was found to have chemical composition similar to asphalt or tar, which has hydrocarbons and sulfur-containing compounds. The Dead Sea mud bath is also known and is also used to relieve acne and pains, reduce stiffness and muscle tension after exercise, and also revitalize the skin. The Dead Sea mud body polish cleans, purifies and stores the skin. The Dead Sea mud skincare product and bath salts are still marketed today. In some of the best spas, wraps and facial masks, which are made from mud and the Dead Sea salts, are used. Cleopatra used perfumes to cover offensive body odor and mask the smell from skin treatment. Chemists have analyzed residues from jars found in Cleopatra's spa and tried reconstructing a number of ancient perfumes using her recipes. They discovered that a favorite ointment was made from moringa oil or horseradish oil. Some chemists have followed her ancient recipes for perfumes that involve mixing herbs, flower petals, leaves or seeds with hot vegetable oil made from pressed olives. They let the mixture soak for a week at 30 to 40 degrees centigrade. Then they press the mixture through a cloth bag to extract the perfumed oil from the pressed olive mixture. Besides perfumed essential oils, Cleopatra used powdered excrement from Egyptian crocodiles to clean and embellish her complexion. Indole, also used in feces, is used in perfumes, and urea, which is a component of urine, is used in modern skincare products and hair colors. To keep her skin soft and supple, Cleopatra bathed in donkey's milk because it contains lactic acid, that is an alpha hydroxy acid, which breaks down dead skin cells, forming milk baths, and several other skincare products contain lactic acid. Cleopatra is said to have used a natural form of baking soda to clean her teeth. Natron was harvested directly, which is a salt mixture from dry lake beds, and this has been for use for thousands of years as a cleaning product for both the home and the body. She is also known to dye her nails, hands, feet and hair with henna. Chemists analyzed the green and black eye paints of Cleopatra. They discovered that the black eye paint called kohl contained galena, which is lead sulfide, and cerussite, which is lead carbonate. On special occasions, she is thought to have added glitter made from crushed shells of beetle mixed with her eye paint. Chemical analysis of the mineral and organic components reveals surprising facts. In addition to the well-known galena and cerussite, two unexpected constituents have been identified: laurionite and phosgenite, which are rare halite minerals found in places where the seawater has weathered lead debris left over from silver mining operations. Researchers believe that the Egyptians have mastered this kind of chemical synthesis and technology more than 4,000 years ago. The history of cosmetics spans thousands of years. The Egyptians are typically regarded as being the first cosmetologists due to archaeological discoveries of their makeup kits and art that depicts their makeup. But the use of cosmetics has been an integral part of every society, from India to Persia, Rome, and Europe. Changes occur with time, and evolution of makeup happened over the years for the quest of beauty. Today, cosmetic is a large industry. So let's take a look at today's cosmetics and their constituents. A variety of organic compounds and inorganic compounds comprise typical cosmetics. Typical organic compounds are modified natural oils and fats, and also a variety of petrochemically derived agents. The inorganic compounds are processed minerals such as iron oxides, talc, and zinc oxides. Iron oxides and zinc oxides are classified as pigments, but they have no solubility in solvents. But besides the active ingredient of the cosmetics, there are other substances along, like water, thickener, color, emulsifier, fragrance, preservatives, and pH stabilizers. Water is used in the formulation of virtually every type of cosmetic and personal care product. Water has been found in lotions, creams, bath products, cleansing products, deodorants, makeup, moisturizers, personal cleanliness products, skin care products, shampoo, hair conditioner, and suntan products. Water plays an important role in this process, as it acts as a solvent to dissolve other ingredients and forms emulsions for consistency. Water used in the formulation of cosmetics is labeled as distilled water or purified water, and this must be free from microbes, toxins, and pollutants. The majority of creams and lotions are emulsions. An emulsion is two immiscible fluids in which one liquid is dispersed as fine droplets in the other. Since oil and water, they do not mix, emulsifiers are added to produce the small droplets and to prevent the oil and water phases from separating. Homogenized milk is an example of an oil in water emulsions. Emulsifiers are used in creams and lotions to give them an even texture. Many cosmetic products are emulsion based. Emulsifiers are added to produce small droplets and to prevent the oil and water phase from separating. Emulsifiers, they change the surface tension between the water and oil, thus producing a homogeneous product with an even texture. For examples, the emulsifiers used in cosmetics include Laureate 4, potassium acetyl sulfate, and polysorbates. Surfactants are perhaps the most important of all cosmetic ingredients. Surfactants have so many useful applications that the cosmetic industry probably wouldn't exist without them. In cosmetics, surfactants are used for cleansing, foaming, thickening, emulsifying, solubilizing, penetration enhancement, antimicrobial effects, and other special effects. Most emulsifiers are surfactants or surface active agents. Shampoos and soap cleaned by the use of surfactants are called as emulsifiers. Surfactant molecules have fat-soluble and water-soluble parts. The lipophilic part of the molecule sticks to the oil and dirt, and the hydrophilic part of water will carry the insoluble grime. In the language of cosmetics, an emollient is a refatting agent. That is an ingredient of a cosmetic formulation that provides the skin with the fat it needs. It reduces evaporation and thus increases the moisture content of the skin. They are used in a wide range of lipsticks, lotions, and cosmetics. A number of different natural and synthetic chemicals work as emollient, including beeswax, olive oil, coconut oil, as well as petroleum jelly, mineral oil, glycerin, zinc oxide, diglycol, laureate. Animal fat composed primarily of stearic acid and palmitic acids were commonly used, but many of the major cosmetic companies are moving away from animal-based materials to renewable vegetable-based materials like coconut oil and palm oil. Petroleum-based emollients such as petroleum jelly and mineral oil are also found in many formulations. Fats and oils are considered to be saturated if they do not have double bonds. Unsaturated oils like olive oils have double bonds, which can react with oxygen, especially when they are heated. The oxidation process can produce off colors and odors in lipids, which causes them to go rancid and unstable, thus making them unstable for use. By combining waxes with different properties such as high shine, flexibility and brittleness, optical cosmetic performance can be achieved. Waxes are particularly useful in hand creams and mascara emulsions for their thickening and waterproofing properties. A thickening agent or a thickener is a substance which can increase the viscosity of a liquid without substantially changing its other properties. Thickening agents used in cosmetics include viscous liquids such as polyethylene glycol, synthetic polymer such as carbomer, and vegetable gums. Some thickening agents may also function as stabilizers when they are used to maintain the stability of an emulsion. Such emollients such as petroleum jelly and various waxes may also function as thickening agents in emulsions. Thickening agents such as polymers are often added to cosmetics to change their consistency. Polymers can be synthetic or derived from natural sources such as polysaccharides. Seaweeds are a common source of natural polysaccharides. Carrageenans extracted from red algae and alginins from brown algae. Some include hydroxyethyl cellulose, xanthan gum, and gelatin. The term cosmeceuticals, coined by famed dermatologist Dr. Albert Lingman, refers to a product that is in between a cosmetic and a drug. Although a cosmetic, by legal definition, can only serve to beautify and protect the surface of the skin, many cosmetic products can be shown to penetrate the dermal layer of the skin to exhibit a physiological change. Fruit acids, also called alpha hydroxy acids, have the ability to penetrate the skin, where they can increase the production of collagen, elastin, and intracellular substances, thus improving the appearance of the skin. Salicylic acid and benzoyl peroxide are important ingredients because of their anti-acne activity. They can be used to suppress perspiration, as in the case of aluminium chlorohydrate. Many active materials are added to skin treatments to protect the skin from the environment. Dimethicone and petrolactam are examples of skin protectants. Coloring agents are central components to some cosmetic products. The number, nature, and official name of coloring agents permitted in cosmetic products vary across countries, though efforts towards international harmonization are in progress. Ruby lips, smoky eyes, and rosy cheeks. It is the purpose of many cosmetics to accentuate or alter a person's natural coloring. Colors can be made from mineral sources such as iron oxide, manganese, etc. Natural colors may come from plants such as beet powder or from animals like the cochineal insect. The latter is often used in red lipstick and referred onto your ingredient list as carmine, cognition extract, or natural red foam. Pigments can be split into two categories, organic, which are carbon-based molecules, and inorganic, which are generally metal oxides. Inorganic should not be confused with synthetic or unnatural, as most of the inorganic metal oxides pigments do not naturally occur as mineral compounds. Pigments and dyes are used in products to impart a color. The two most common organic pigments are lakes and toners. The lake pigments are made by combining a dye with an insoluble substance like alumina hydrate. This causes the dye to become insoluble in water, making it suitable for cosmetics where water resistant or waterproof properties are desired. A toner pigment is an organic pigment that has not been combined with any other substances. Cosmetics and beauty products are made up of ingredients that are biodegradable, and this means that microbes can easily break them down. This causes a product to become unsafe and unpleasant for consumers with an added antimicrobial. This basically means that preservatives are antimicrobial ingredients which are added to product formulation to maintain the microbiological safety of the product, which stops the growth and reduces the amount of microbiological contaminants. They are added to cosmetics to extend their shelf life and prevent the growth of other microorganisms such as bacteria and fungi, which can spoil the product and possibly harm the user. Since most microbes live in water, the preservatives used need to be water soluble, and this helps to determine which ones are used. Preservatives used in cosmetics can be natural or synthetic and perform differently depending on the formulation of the products. Esters of parabenzoic acids are by far the most commonly used because of their effectiveness against gram-positive bacteria. Fragrances are complex combination of natural and or man-made substances that are added to many consumer products to give them a distinctive smell. Fragrance or perfume, they are a mixture of essential oils or aroma compounds, which is used to give the body odor a pleasant scent. The fragrances are used in a variety of products to impart a pleasant odor, mask the inherent smell of ingredients, and enhance the experience of using the product. Fragrances can create important benefits that are tangible and valued. They can solve the important functional problems and satisfy valued emotional needs. Fragrance can communicate complex ideas like signaling cleanliness, freshness, or softness, elevating stress, creating well-being, and triggering allure and attraction. Chemicals, both natural and synthetic, they are added to cosmetics to provide an appealing fragrance. Although unscented products may contain masking fragrances, other chemicals are also used. The term fragrance is often a generic term used by manufacturer. A single listing of fragrances on your product's ingredient list could represent dozens or even thousands of unlisted chemical compounds which were used to create the final individual fragrance. Manufacturers do not have to list these individual ingredients, as fragrance is considered to be a trade secret. If consumers are considered, they should look for fragrance-free product and buy from companies that label their products more comprehensively. Fragrances aren't just in perfumes. They are also in creams, lotions, and even in food to give an appealing smell. In our pursuit of beauty, we must remember that cosmetics are a complex combination of chemicals. Although skincare product manufacturers must follow the rules and regulations that apply to cosmetics. However, cosmetics do not require FDA approval before being introduced in the market. Skincare products must not be misbranded or adulterated, but they need not require to prove efficacy or safety to the FDA. Cosmetics are more self-regulated than other products, such as food and drugs. Achieving an understanding of the chemical names on a product ingredient list, their function, their health effects, can help consumers make more informed decisions about the products they choose to use. Thank you for watching this module. We shall see you in our next module.